The first time I experienced what the ocean had to offer was when I scuba dived on my 10th birthday. 10-year-old me was more than amazed. After all, it was the first time I'd seen fish swim in something other than curry. To swim alongside entire schools of fish of every color and pattern, racing and hiding, interacting with each other, was such a surreal experience. It felt as though I had been allowed to enter a world so magical, it just had to be fantasy. It's been over 5 years since I discovered the underwater world for myself. Over the years, diving for me has evolved from being just a fun adventure to an opportunity to enter a world we so desperately need to understand and protect. I get to see firsthand the treasures of the ocean, treasures that are in danger of disappearing forever. Every dive I go on makes me feel like I can understand the ocean just a little bit better. Every dive I go on shows me how intricate and fragile life is, how complex relations are, how the biggest fish depend on the tiniest plankton, so small that you cannot see them with your naked eyes. Every organism, living or non-living, big or small, makes a difference. I think of how lucky I am to be able to witness this. I think of those who haven't yet. And with the way we treat our oceans, those who may never get to. Because somehow we've convinced ourselves that everything this earth has to offer, from its oceans to its forests, is ours to take. We raid the oceans, getting the food of millions from it, and we dump our trash right there. One of the best, or I suppose worst, examples of overexploitation of marine resources is trawling. Trawling is one of the most dangerous and, unfortunately, one of the most common fishing techniques used today. Let me explain how trawling works. Enormous cone-shaped nets open at one end are pulled through the ocean by one or two boats. As these nets are towed, they catch any and every creature in their path. A part of these, of course, are eaten by you and me, but a major part of what is caught is not consumed. Since trawling is highly indiscriminate, it also catches many species which aren't consumed. These nets are normally around 330 feet wide and 40 feet high. This is a single trawling net containing 12 Boeing 727 aircrafts in it. One single fishing net. Since trawling is highly indiscriminate, it also catches many species that aren't consumed, like starfish, rays, sea turtles, even whales and dolphins. Trawling also catches the juvenile of these species, children. The thing about trawling is that the size of the net can outweigh the size of the boat by many, many times. And this is possible because these nets are not pulled up to the surface as soon as the fish are caught. Instead, these nets, filled with sea creatures, are dragged across the rocky seabed for miles up to the shore. At the shore, they're pulled up to the surface where fishermen segregate what will be consumed, the catch, and what won't be consumed, the bycatch. Bycatch normally outweighs the catch by 2 to 10 times. And then all these beautiful animals are thrown back into the oceans, dead or dying, killed for absolutely no reason. It's a meaningless massacre of life. Furthermore, as these nets are pulled across the ocean, they also crush any sea creature living on the ocean bed, from crabs and snails to corals and sponges. A patch of ocean that was once brimming with life is wiped clean within a matter of minutes. Trawling turns physically diverse environments into barren deserts. Trawlers are the bulldozers of oceans, scooping up and destroying everything in their path. In the 30 or so fishing villages in and around Mumbai, many fishermen have started to use trawl boats to get their catch. Maharashtra itself has more than 4,500 trawlers, and we saw the size of these nets. Due to this increasing number of trawlers and decreasing number of fish, fishermen have to go further and further into the seas for every trip, because there are only a limited number of fish in the sea. In low seasons, fishing trips can last up to 3 weeks and even longer till that fish reaches your plate. The ocean seems huge and never-ending. Some think it's limitless in its capacity. It's certainly not. Nearly 90% of our world's fish stocks have been fully exploited or depleted. We have to realize that the ocean is not just some source of food for us. It's a home to countless organisms. Our earth is not something we can use and throw. It is our responsibility to repair the damage that we have caused to it. The good news is that the world is becoming more and more aware every day. And if there aren't initiatives that we can come up with ourselves, there are always those that we can support and donate to. Recently, as a student of the 10th grade, I've had to think about my interests, my capabilities, and my aptitude, so that I could decide for myself my career, my future. I've loved the water in every shape and form all my life. I immediately knew I would love to have a career where I could interact with ocean life. Somehow, in an environment where I could not breathe without the metal tanks strapped to my back, in water I could not consume, in a world I could never inhabit, is where I feel most alive. My dream is to become a marine biologist. But when I realized this, I had to ask myself a question I hated. I said to myself, Tamanna, 20, 30 years from now, when you would like to be completely invested in your career, will there even be a thriving ocean to explore? Will there ever be new species of fish for you to research when the ones we have today are disappearing so rapidly? When you find something, a cause you're willing to dedicate your life to, and you're forced to doubt yourself because of circumstances you individually cannot control, it's a heartbreaking feeling. I see parents in this room, adults who have found and established their place in this world. We children are yet to do so. We still have to find our place, our future. You have to let us live out our dreams. You have to save this planet to save your children. Save them from a future where the air is toxic and polluted, where forests have vanished, where the oceans are filled with more plastic than fish. If we don't want to be one of the last few generations of humans on this planet, we need to change the way we act, think, and live. I know saving the planet seems like such a huge and mammoth task, but we each have our small part to play. And just like each of you taught your children, when there is a will, there is a way.